Vermilion to Middle Bass Island. Got me another convoy going like last year. Just want to get this shot. So I'm sitting here at a bar in Middle Bass Island, and I see a game right away I recognize from Norris Lake. Look at this. Let's try and get this thing in.
Oh, you suck.
I suck. Hold on.
Let me show you how it's done.
Yeah, hold on. Let's see how it's done. Hey, let's see how it's done.
Ready?
Let's go. Let's go.
Second try.
Oh, I think you're cheating. But hey, that's how it's done. There you go.
This game is called Bimini.
Bimini, there you go.
It started Bimini Islands.
My nephews, now you know. All right. Hey, checking in from Middle Bass Island State Park. And behind me, you can see where my boat, the Leena Marie, is docked. Came in last night, had a really great time, but wanted to share some video from where we're at. It's a very beautiful marina, so I figure might as well share some with you. So there's a boat, and behind me you can see Lake Erie, and you can see a little bit, I think, of Pelee Island, that Canadian island. But and you got the flags from the yacht club that also has dockage here. You see the right behind over there. They won't even sell me ice. You hear that? They won't even sell the Chuckster 22 ice. Insane. But that being said, it's a very beautiful place, and I just wanted to share that with you. So, there you are. I want to share some more close-up video of the beach area by our boats over here. It's beautiful, so it's definitely worth sharing. Like I said, I think over there, there's a little small island, but on the horizon, you should be able to see, where is that? Right there. You should be able to see Pelee Island over there. On the other side of the island, which you can't see, you'd be able to see Put-in Bay behind me over there, but this is it. So just going to show some video from this area. All right, now I'm at the beach. It's a little beach here at Middle Bass Island, and behind me, I've got some close-up film of someone who's actually parasailing out here in Lake Erie, Ohio. So you gotta love that. So just a wonderful place to be, and just more proof that Ohio is a pretty awesome place to be as well. We got parasailing too, not just places like Miami in the Caribbean. We have it too in Lake Erie. So just want to share that with you from the beach here at Middle Bass Island. Right behind me now is Lon's Winery, a very historic winery here in Ohio, on Middle Bass Island. Several years ago, it got burnt down in the fire, but they came and they renovated it, and it's back in its old glory. But this is a winery that goes back far in Ohio's history, one of the original wineries here on the islands. So just wanted to share it with you. I'm told they don't really have wine anymore, so I think it may be more of a restaurant these days, but I'm gonna go inside and check it out. Also, I wanted to share right across the street from Lon's Winery here in Middle Bass is none other than Put-in Bay. You can see Put-in Bay behind me. There's the Perry Monument. We've talked about that before. Marks a victory, the Battle of Lake Erie, where he gathered his ships right before he defeated the British. And during that battle, proclaimed the phrase, "Don't give up the ship." But that's another video for another time. Right now, just want to focus on Lon's Winery. Okay, I am now actually inside Lon's Winery, which is a museum of the old winery itself. They said I could take some pictures and shoot some film, so I'm just going to be sharing you with some other stuff. But as you see here, I'm in one of the barrel rooms, which is pretty cool. But my understanding is everything here is just a museum for the winery that once was. So let's look at some footage of this place. I felt like I just got thrown in the dungeon over here. Look at this place. But I'm not in the dungeon. I'm just still checking out the winery. See the big room behind me over there. As I'm walking through this winery, it's really cool to see some of the old tools on display that they used to make wine back in the day. Of course, we have the infamous barrel behind me, but also what's pretty cool is you can see some old grape crushers that they had and the tractor that they used to plow the fields, I guess, to grow the vines. But just want to show you that, and we'll give you a closer shot of them. But pretty cool when you see the history that's in this building, and that's a part of our history here in Ohio, making wine. And just want to give you a closer shot as promised, and I'm guessing that's what they use to crush the grapes. I'm not sure what that is, but you know that's a part of the process. And then you got the tractor, which also got some other photographs in. But who knows how this stuff is? I'm guessing well over 100 years old. And there's some more accessories for the trip. Well, that's it for the Lon's Winery tour. Do got to correct myself on one thing. I spoke with the tour guide there, and apparently there's no restaurant, no winery, strictly the museum with a patio that's just for sitting. But that's okay. Plenty of alcohol on this island. I'm good to go. I'm plenty of alcohol on my boat, so I'm more than good to go. But just wanted to share that with you, and glad I got to share this place. Very historic a very wonderful place. So hope you enjoy. And of course, no trip to the islands is complete until I've finally got to walk amongst some grapes. So here's a small little grape display for the park of what we grow here in Ohio. Concord, Catawba, Niagara, just to name a few. So just a small little grape patch. Little vineyard action for folks to enjoy.
Close up of some grapes. Give me a little time, let me clear up my mind. Give me a little
time, let me clear up my mind. Give me a little time. I don't know if it's because it's Christmas in July, but for some reason this little lone standing grapevine reminds me of Charlie Brown's Christmas tree. What do you think? So real quickly here, I also want to share with you this old house the tour guide told me about. I guess this was just a boat house for the people who owned the winery way back in the 1920s or so. Before the other stuff, there's a hotel and some big mansion over at the winery that all burnt down in a big fire in the 1920s. But this boat house is the only thing that really survived all of that. So she felt important to tell me about it, so I figured I might as well come take a look and share it with you. What I am now standing on is actual glacier rock formed during the Ice Age here on this island that here in 2018 still remains. So I just stumbled on this when I was walking around the winery, so I wanted to go ahead and share this with you. But take a closer look. All of that is glacier rock. And I might as well show you this little swamp that's behind me over here too. It's pretty cool. But yeah, right next to the glacier rock, you got a little swamp. So anyhow, just wanted to share that with you.
What is that I see over the horizon of the boats? Lest you forget, do not forget, it's Christmas in July. There's Santa to party with us.
All right, here on my last day, or was supposed to be my last day here at Middle Bass Island. As you can see behind me, there's white caps everywhere. Apparently there's waves as high as 7 feet out there, so we might be staying an extra day. As luck would have it, tomorrow is 1 feet or less. So that's the way Lake Erie goes sometimes. It can turn on a dime, but figure I might as well share some of these waves with you since I'm looking at them.
Riders on the storm. Riders on the storm.
What we have down here, guys, is our resident snake. Been trying to get him on film the whole time. Now, these guys are harmless here in Ohio, but he is kind of a big fella. So I do want to share them with you. even as he's hiding underneath the rock. And see, he's just slipping under there some more. Always trying to hide from us. But there he is. Alright, so as already said, I'm stuck here on the island for a day until the water calms down. There's nothing to do, so what else to do? I rent a bicycle, and when exploring the island, something I wanted to do anyway, and pretty surprised to find out it's a little smaller than I thought. I was able to ride this little bicycle all the way from one end of the island, where our boats are, to this, the opposite end. Here I am at the end of my trail. Went by the airport earlier, a little small airport, a couple little small Cessna planes, no big deal. And yeah, I got this bike for another hour or so, so I'm gonna go do some more exploring, but just wanted to share this part too. Just more fun activities here on Middle Bass Island. Alright, I'm still out here with my bike, exploring Middle Bass Island, and got a little closer to the airport, and just want to share a couple of the planes with you. Like I said, little Cessnas, I think they are. But still, that's for folks who likes to fly in and not boat in. So there you go. Just wanted to share that with you. So here it is. I've come to the end of my trail, the dead end, this big stop sign, the end of Middle Bass Island. I rode this bicycle all the way from our marina site, from one end of the island to here, the very end of the island. So nice bike ride, pretty proud that I did. If you can see behind me, you can see that on this side of the island, the lake really is very choppy. Good thing I didn't take the boat out on that, but just wanted to share you what it looks like here on the other end. I'll be heading back to the boat now. Quick stop on my bike ride back. Just want to share this pretty cool little trail that I cut through on my way down here. Just kind of take a look. A lot of beautiful nature down that way. And that's the way back to the boat, by the way. That's where I'm headed. But wanted to share that with you. Now I'm going to continue with my bike ride. This must be the big fish that got away. Checking out the view, I guess. All right, one more thing I want to show you here on my bike ride right across from the airport. They actually have some really cool nature preserve wetlands here behind me on Middle Bass Island. It's a pretty cool thing to see. Looks like one of those deals where the state is reserving this so wildlife can do what it does. And the nice thing about that is we get to enjoy it. Just enjoy this natural beauty. So wanted to share that with you, and here it is. Just want to get another video of our friend by the docks. This time I got him, and he's just kind of watching me, watching him. But I wanted to share him with you to show you what he is up to. Boy, he's just staying still now. But that's our dock snake. They're Middle Bass. And I just want to shoot him one more time with a better camera angle. There he is, chilling at the docks. He's a big guy, I tell you. I think he's got himself a happy home over here. There, Middle Bass. See where he's at. And of course, that's all of our boats. And there's the snake doing this thing. Want to share a video of something you don't get to see every day. Two Ohio iconic structures on two separate islands side by side. From this position where I'm at, the Peary Monument looks a lot closer than what I think it really is.
You can see that on the right, and on the left, you can see the Lawns Winery. And there they are, side by side, but in reality, looking across each other from the, in between the lake there. But I was walking back from somewhere and I saw this and I had to share it with you.
Yeah.